Well, I want to welcome everybody. I think I need to explain, I'm from the northwest corner of the state, a place called Harding County, but now I live in the southwest corner of the state, which is Kyle, South Dakota, and I went to Texas to school, so. I'm a Harding County girl that moved to Pine Ridge Indian Reservation. So I've done a lot of things, and when I first got married and moved to the reservation, there wasn't much call for computer language or insurance adjusters. So I had a good friend that was teaching at a local school there in Shannon County and wanted me to get involved with the school. So I did. Well, ended up being in the classroom for several years, and my last group of kids was in fifth grade, and then I quit teaching. So I do have some experience in the classroom. That's the first thing I want to say. I also own a grocery store. And you probably all think I'm crazy. I've done about everything. Now I have a grocery store. I've had it for 10 years. They were talking about the math, and this gal here asked, you know, was questioning, have you been in the classroom? Well, I've been in the classroom, but now I own a business. And I've got this young girl that works for me, brilliant, straight A student, calculus. She's done every hard math class that the school offers. She works for me. She cannot do basic math. I have a walk-in cooler. We have pallets of milk. They come in. There'll be eight on this side, eight on this side. She doesn't know eight plus eight, eight times two. She counts. See how many boxes. So, common core, I'm kind of like Jim, it's just instinctive. As soon as I started reading about it, hearing about it, and all of this, it's not that I think that leadership is bad, maybe. The education department is bad. I think it's like a lot of us, uninformed. And being uninformed is going to get us in trouble, get us in real trouble. And as a business owner, I see it every day. I have kids come in every day wanting a job. They want a job. There's almost 90% unemployment. Had a young man come in a couple weeks ago, 22 years old, never had a job. He wanted his first job. So I said, well, what have you done? If you went to school, what are your qualifications? He said, I graduated from the local school there, but I have to tell you, I can't read. I said, these kids, you never know if they're joking with you or what. I said, oh, really? I said, surely you can read. You don't have to work in a grocery store. And there's tags on my shelf tags, we call them, with the product and the price. And I point to it, and I say, can you read this? I can tell you what the numbers are, but I can't read those words. I had a great education. I went to a one-room schoolhouse in the middle of the prairie. Eight grades, 13 students, one teacher. I think it would be called a private school today. I know people get tired of hearing this, especially teachers. Both my kids are teachers. But we need to get back to some basics. I like to listen to, my daughter, she's, educated. She has a whole lot of stories she tells me. But when it comes to some common sense, my kids even laugh at that. I'm kind of a gym. I'm down at the state. Why I'm there, I don't know. I'm a really bad politician, pretty good representative, but a really bad politician. I've got one more year down there. I'm going to back Jim on this Common Core. encourage you, if there's anything that you can do for us, is to be visible and be heard. Because I had somebody in leadership tell me, Liz, quit worrying about your vote. The people don't care about your vote. It's serious. They think that nobody is paying attention. We have to, you have to make them understand that you are paying attention and you do care. We're not going to agree all the time. It would be a really boring world if we always agreed on everything. But we have to agree that we want our children to have the best possible education that we can give them. And that doesn't mean Stanford or Virginia Tech or, I mean, not everybody is college material. So, I guess I'll let Jim, call your legislators, especially call your senators down the state. I sit on the Ed Committee. I heard Jim's testimony. The testimony was fantastic. We skimmed it out of the Ed Committee. We got it to the House floor. And this is another point I want to make. This isn't about Republicans and Democrats. Let's get this straight. It was split right down the middle. This isn't about conservative, liberal. This has nothing to do with party lines. This has to be about being informed and knowing what the consequences are. And let me tell you, from where I stand, the consequences are severe. Because my husband and I stay in 5 years, who are we going to get to help us run our business? Seriously, we say that to ourselves, because right now the youngest person I have in my store is 42 years old. Because I can't find anybody. I can't find any young people. I've spent $50,000 on scanners so they don't have to count change, because you can't find anybody to count change. Nobody. So call your senators, call your representatives, make your voices heard, pass the message out, talk to all your friends, all your teachers that are teaching your kids, school board members. I had a school board member ask me, she's been sitting on the school board 4 years, she said, what's Common Core? And she's an intelligent woman. So it's not anybody's fault, it's planned. They didn't want anybody knowing about. So get out, get the message out. That's it.